Acting Captain's Log, Stardate 59522.3. We have arrived at the Tantalus 5 penal colony to interview an inmate. Captain Shelby's on assignment for Admiral Nechayev.
Commander Naros, isn't it?
Yes. You remember Lieutenant McCabe?
I remember him threatening me and tossing me around his brig.
We need some information, Captain Mason.
I told him everything when the Independents captured me.
When you were interrogated by Commodore Cole, you refused to name your employer. Was it him? You found Serok his tetrahedron keys.
If you know everything, why come to me?
You know quite a bit about the keys, don't you?
I was little more than an errand boy.
These artifacts have something to do with the Grey, but two of them aren't enough. We have to find the others.
I don't know anything.
Serok has left you alone because he believes you are of little consequence. You're of great consequence to me, Captain Mason, because I believe you can help me find more keys.
You give me far too much credit.
I give you enough credit to know that I can inform Serok that you know about more keys.
And why would he believe you? He hates you.
He believes me because he hates me. I neglected to introduce our ship's counselor, Commander Elbry. She's a Benazoid.
Reading my mind is a violation of my rights, Commander.
Which is why you're going to give us your permission.
And why would I do that?
If you refuse, you become the new target for Sorek's vengeance. You don't think his powers can reach as far as Tantalus 5, or Molina 4, your family's home?
There was a third key. I hid it. Free me, and I'll tell you where it is.
No deals until after we've accessed your memories.
Fine.
Counselor?
Your mind's been read before. You know Milo Sagant.
Serok's Starfleet operative. Friend of yours, Counselor?
Counselor?
I'll be fine, Commander. The key is on the Orion Syndicate's homeworld. There's a complication. Only he can open the vault that the key is held in.
Which means you're going to have to take me along.
personal log, stardate 59534.3. The Federation is helping our allies prepare their ships for the difficult conditions of the Briar Patch. Meanwhile, Admiral Nechayev has assigned me to accompany a Romulan task force on a shakedown cruise deep inside the Briar Patch.
Commander Leffler, I've noted that the refit of the Romulan ships took longer than you estimated.
Yes, Admiral. The Romulans were reluctant to let us have too close a peek at their propulsion systems.
Captain Shelby, I reviewed your itinerary. You're taking them very deep into the patch.
On Commander Nostrom's recommendation.
Given the Romulans' different warp propulsion, I believe it's important to tune their engines under conditions similar to those that we're likely to encounter in battle, Admiral.
I'd like to have an additional command officer go along. Someone with experience in that particular region of the patch. Nechayev to Ops. Send the captain in. Mac. Captain Calhoun. You know Captain Shelby and Commander Leffler. This is Commander Benjamin Ostrom, Chief Engineer on the Valley Forge.
Captain, it's an honor.
As you were, Commander. Admiral, with all due respect, I'm sure you have other captains more qualified to babysit the Romulans than me.
Consider this my calling in one of the many markers you owe me.
I thought I paid off those markers a long time ago.
And I thought my orders wouldn't be questioned. Especially by you, Mackenzie.
Leffler to Shelby. 5 minutes to rendezvous point.
Mac, talk to me.
I go where I'm ordered.
Ordered to work with the people who destroyed your first Excalibur.
You don't think I have the right to a grudge? Epi, a lot of people you knew were killed by those bastards.
Mac, not a day goes by that I don't think about them. But times change. We need allies.
You know I've never been one to give up a well-earned grudge. Easily. Elizabeth, what's wrong?
Why didn't you tell me you were in the patch? You've been here for over a year, and not one word.
I was under orders to remain silent. Look, Nechayev thinks there's something shady going on with this Gray research facility. She wanted her own eyes and ears out here.
You've broken the rules before.
Yes, I have. But I used to have a first officer who would have chastised me for doing just that.
Captains, we're on approach to the Romulan task force.
The mission is undercover and classified. You'll fly to the Orion homeworld in an unmarked vessel. Excelsior will wait outside the system for your signal. Mr. McKay will be in command. He can answer any remaining questions. Good luck.
Lieutenant McCabe, why does Mason have to accompany us?
The security system he described used a complicated series of biometric locks. He needs to be physically present to get in and back out again. If there are no further questions, we leave at 0800. Dismissed.
Starfleet is infuriating, Nevin.
Oh, what is today's complaint from the Federation News Service?
I had to beg for information about why Captain Shelby handed over command to Narrows. Nobody will tell me why we visited a penal colony. And now we're on a mission so secret, I'm not even allowed to know where we are. Isn't that Cori Astor sitting all alone over there? I heard he and Zen are fighting.
Where did you hear that?
I'm a reporter.
What are you doing?
I'm going to invite him over.
Avis, don't!
Cori Astor, your antisocial behavior must stop.
Tara, good evening.
I'm determined to cheer you up, so, haul your Terran butt over to our table.
I wouldn't want to intrude.
I don't know if you've noticed, but even though Ronevin is very dreamy looking, his conversational skills could use more of your influence.
Sorry, Cori. She slipped her leash.
I'm going to go let the waiter know we've moved over here. The Terha is quite an impressive ship, Commander Yervik.
Thank you, Captain. I look forward soon to sharpening her claws on Tholian crystal. Captain Calhoun, what is the plan for this mission?
Strictly shakedown, Commander.
It appears our engineers will soon complete their tests. In the meantime, perhaps you two will join me on the Krayriov for dinner.
We'd be honored, Commander.
We secured a docking slip near Mason's storage facility. Mr. Mason, we'll need you to get us through the front door. We'll go through the interior security checkpoint where they'll transport us to the storage vault. We'll retrieve the key and we'll transport back to the ship.
There's something wrong, McCabe. The storage facility advertises it uses external transport inhibitors for added security.
You did not mention this before. No one asked.
This is no way to plan a mission.
This scenario will require greater diligence from us while inside the facility.
Mason sticks with me. Sital, you take point. Barrett, bring up the rear.
Are you sure that's best? Maybe I should take the point.
Sital's a better shot than you are, Andy.
Andrew, I do not believe it was appropriate of you to question McCabe's orders.
Sital, I was just thinking...
I do not believe you were thinking. I believe you were feeling concerned for me. McCabe gave logical assignments.
Sital...
Your intent was admirable, Andrew. But your duty must take priority over your emotions for me.
Which one of you is Mason?
That's me.
You only paid for a two-person entry. I can't let these other two pass.
I'll go with Mason. Meet us at the exit.
Okay.
My partner will escort you to the side exit. You two, follow me.
This isn't good. We need to find McCabe.
You are leaving the building.
Not quite yet.
Energy dampeners. This is a secure facility. Now move along.
Good work. Now, mind meld with him and find out how to get us into the vault.
Come on! That's the second explosion! Quit wasting time and open the box now!
Why, Mr. Barrett, how delightful to see you again.
Computer, energize. There!
Oh. They erased the coordinates! Second. I suspect the mind of that unconscious guard holds the information we seek.
Matt, we've got trouble.
Those explosions?
Petros and Sergeant.
We have to get out of here. Now!
The transporter inhibitor fields have been damaged by the explosions.
We can transport out of here?
Not all at once. The inhibitors are fluctuating. I suggest you take the key and Mason with you first.
McCabe to scout ship. Prepare to transport too. Follow us immediately. Computer, energize.
The key has an extremely dense quantum signature. The transporter cannot lock onto it and the two humans through the inhibitor fields.
We need to get it back to the ship, Tal. The key is more important than I am.
Andrew.
Put down the key and step back, Lieutenant.
Computer, prepare transport for two.
No!
Computer, energize.
Energy dampeners. Sorry.
We have other weapons at our disposal, Mr. Barrett. Sergeant?
Where are they, Lieutenant?
Ah!
Tell me.
To hell with you.
Ah!
I have it.
Where is he?
It is likely he has succumbed to their assault, sir.
Then he knows where we are. Serac knows.
Without his active signal, we cannot get a transporter lock. We must assume our location has been compromised.
We can't just leave him.
You know, we must.
Prepare for liftoff.
What'll it be?
I'll sit back there. Could you bring me a glass of Perrins?
Perrins? Well, it's a farmer's drink. Wouldn't you want something a little bit, more adventurous?
Just a Perrins, thanks.
One Perrins, nice and strong.
Yeah, thanks.
Enjoy your drink.
Did you program her to flirt with you?
Flirt?
You're so dense sometimes.
Thanks for coming.
Nevin, I changed my appearance like you asked. But why am I here? It's 0200.
I needed to talk and I wanted a place where I'd be more comfortable. Dressing you up was just for fun. You look good as a Bajoran.
You don't have to be nervous.
Right. Well, look, I need to confess something. I lied.
Lied?
When you first came aboard the Inke mission, I lied.
About what?
I told you I didn't remember you from the academy. The terraforming class we both had, I was failing it.
I know.
I know you knew. A pad with all the notes to prepare for the final exam mysteriously showed up in my dorm room. I know you gave me those notes. How? I asked around. You didn't cover your tracks very well.
And you never said anything. Ever.
I didn't know what to say. Or what I was feeling. And so I lied. And I kept lying, and I'm tired of it. And I need to tell you, and I need to tell Avis what I'm feeling.
And what are you feeling?
I love you, Corey. Look, I know my timing is terrible, and this is the last thing you need to hear with everything going on between you and Zen, but I...
Let's just sit with this for a while, okay?
Corey... Computer. End program.
Status report, Commander Leffler.
Impulse manifolds checked out. Now we're ready to test warp modifications.
Very good. Helm ahead 3/4 impulse and confirm launch point coordinates.
Launch point confirmed. All vessels at 3/4 impulse.
Centurion, prepare tachyon burst on my mark.
All vessels standing by.
Mark. Ahead, warp 5. Captains, dinner in 30 minutes then? I hope you find your meals to your liking, Captains.
Zenetian trilia steak. It's my favorite.
And the salmon is prepared just the way I like it. What is the point of having a spite on?
You're Tal Shiar, aren't you?
Hardly, Captain Calhoun. I only conducted research. Allow me to share some other fruits of my curiosity. Don't you recognize this man? His name is Graphon Tolar. Surely you remember him. He was a very gifted holographic forger. On Stardate 51711, during the Dominion War, your esteemed Admiral Nechayev turned to her favorite operative, you, Captain Calhoun, for a favor. She ordered the Excalibur to transport Tolar from the Klingon Empire to Deep Space Nine. After you deposited him there, Tolar was never seen again.
Is there a point to your lecture, Commander?
Well, this was mere prologue, my dear Captain. This is where the lecture begins. Are you too familiar with the circumstances under which the Romulan Empire joined the war on your side?
Of course. Your Senator Vrenak was killed by Dominion operatives on Sakura.
He carried information proving the Dominion attack on Romulus.
Holographic information, Calhoun, on a Cardassian data rod. And what your superiors have never revealed is that Senator Vrenak paid a visit to your Captain Sisko on Deep Space Nine to hear, guess what, evidence about Dominion plans to attack Romulus. Just days after you and Shelby deposited Tolar there.
How do we know any of what you're saying is true, Yervik?
Senator Vrenak was my mentor. I served on his staff. I've investigated everything I could about Deep Space Nine around that time. There's a trail of evidence. Payoffs to smugglers. A complaint about Sisko's behavior to Starfleet Medical by the chief medical officer. Sightings of Tolar with key Starfleet and Bajoran personnel. Deleted security records kept by the very paranoid station security chief.
So what's your point?
The Federation forged that data rod and had Vrenak killed, making it look like the Dominion was responsible, so that we would ally with you against them.
We do not do that kind of thing, Yervik.
Frankly, this smells more like a Romulan plot.
You can lose the superior tone, Calhoun. Our empire has come to your aid twice in the past decade, and still the Federation portrays itself as the morally superior galactic power.
Fine. You have your evidence. What do you want from us?
To admit your complicity in the death of my mentor. To admit your lofty Federation runs in the same gutter you accuse we inferior powers of inhabiting. To let your superiors know we are not fools. You're falling out of orbit.
Commander, we've lost main power.
I want a status report by the time I reach the command deck, Centurion.
Captains, join me.
Report!
Primary systems are down. We have no energy to power secondary systems. Batteries are keeping life support at nominal.
The other ships?
As near as I can tell, the same. All we have is thrusters, internal communication, and short-range sensors.
Maybe our communicators work. Shelby Leffler.
Captain, we can barely hear you.
Can we fix this?
It'll take time. And I'll need access to the propulsion subsystems that we were barred from before.
Captain Shelby, I cannot authorize that access.
I've just checked our position. We're in a part of the patch the Tholians patrol heavily, with only short-range sensors. We're sitting ducks.
Ducks?
Easy prey, Commander.
I see. I authorize Leffler's access. Captain Shelby, would you raise Engineer Nostrum aboard the Terra? Captain Calhoun, could I have a word? How bad is our situation?
We're close to a Tholian space lane. Commander, if I might suggest, we came aboard in an Argo-class shuttle. It's well-suited to operating in the patch. I could use it to coordinate repairs and possibly give us some warning if any Tholians do approach.
I agree. Launch as quickly as you can.
Calhoun to Shelby, Leffler, and Nostrum. Can you read me?
Aye, Captain.
Aye, Captain.
Aye, Captain.
Very well, then. Let's get busy. I'll monitor from here. Calhoun to Shelby. We've just been scanned. Tholian patrol vessel is 20 minutes distant at full impulse.
The Terha and the Gollage are still 45 minutes away from restoring power. We need to increase our odds. Mac, how far away is the nearest Metreon cloud large enough to hide a ship in?
About 8 minutes if I help their thrusters with my tractor beam.
Commander, they will be out of transporter and communication range, but they'll be safely hidden.
Signal the Gollage.
Commander, we've restored short-range communication using our shuttles.
Thank you for the idea, Captain.
I have one other, Commander, if I may. Take this to a shuttle with a functioning transporter. We may need it later.
Attend to it, Centurion.
Commander, a Tholian patrol vessel approaches. Web spinner class, 200,000 kilometers distance.
Helm, fire thrusters! Move us into position between the Tholians' anticipated trajectory and the Terra.
You're gonna shield your other ship?
Commander, the Tholians will be within firing range in 60 seconds.
Hail them, Commander.
There's no reasoning with a Tholian, Captain.
This is your bridge, Commander, but I know the Tholians. You need to buy whatever time you can to give the Terra a fighting chance.
30 seconds, Commander.
Captain Shelby, you may indeed possess a Romulan mind. Centurion, hail the Tholians! Explain our predicament. Request assistance.
Commander, the Tholians are telling us to prepare to be boarded.
Captain, get a status report from your engineer.
I'll try to buy more time, as you put it. Invoke our rights under the Kittimer Accords to arbitration by a neutral third party. I knew that insufferable document would one day serve some useful purpose.
Commander, damage repair cadre reports. Successful rerouting of power from batteries to shields. Shield power at 32%.
Better than nothing.
Shields at 21%. Commander, one more direct shot and they will collapse.
I've been dodging you bastards for a year. Not anymore.
Mac. Shelby took Calhoun. Can you get your ship to a pocket of Metreon gas?
What do you have in mind, Effie?
A little blind man's bluff. Transmit the coordinates of the Metreon pocket, Mac.
You got it.
Commander, please trust me. Have the Centurion follow my instructions.
Do it.
Order the officer who has my phaser to set it on overload with a 3-second countdown. Have him transfer it from his shuttle to these coordinates on my mark.
I'm in the pocket.
Get out of there. Maximum speed, Mac. Mark.
Report. The explosion collapsed their shields completely. Warp drive heavily damaged. Impulse is offline. They have short-range sensors and partial power to their disruptors.
How much time did Captain Shelby buy us, Centurion?
I estimate 30 minutes to repair their impulse drive.
Hail the Terra. Mr. Nostrum, will 30 minutes be enough to bring main power back online?
I believe it will, Captain.
Double time, Mr. Nostrum.
Calhoun to Kuryov. I'm going to take this opportunity to do some damage to that web spinner.
No, Mac. They still have targeting sensors and weapons, and you're heavily damaged. Right now, we have more shields than you do. Get back here.
Elizabeth.
Don't make me lock a tractor beam on you.
Aye, aye, Captain.
Federation shuttle has docked, and Captain Calhoun is on his way here. Commander, I'm reading an incoming torpedo.
Fire thrusters, move us out of range.
It's moving too fast, Commander.
All hands, brace for impact. Report.
Our shields are gone, Commander. The thrusters are inoperative, and Commander, they're using thrusters to move it to disruptor range. Too soon for the Terra to complete repairs. They are within range, Commander.
Status of the Terra.
Main power, 10 minutes away. The Tholians are charging weapons.
You have all done the Empire proud. And you, your Federation.
Personal log, stardate 59572.1. With main power restored, we're returning to Deep Space 12.
I owe you thanks, Captains. You and your colleagues have proved your nobility, your honor, your willingness to sacrifice yourselves for your allies.
What you saw, Commander, was teamwork. Our people and yours in common cause. Again. That's what the Federation is really about.
All the more reason I ask you to consider what I have told you. If you care for your Federation, hold them accountable to their ideals.
You've given us, and me, a lot to think about, Yervek.
That's all I can ask, Captain. Now, if you'll excuse me, my place is on the command deck as we make our final approach to your starbase. Enjoy your dessert.
So, what do we do now? Who do we talk to about this? If what Yervik says is true.
Well, I've just finished Macheev's little jaunts around the patch. I'll take this to the Federation Council. I will make them listen to me. Elizabeth, you know that I'm no good with my emotions. But when you tried to defend the Terhad, it looked like...
That's why I transferred off of Excalibur. Our emotions got in the way of our duty.
You're right. Of course. Epi, just don't think that duty is a permanent choice. One day, we can choose happiness too.
Heck.
Good night, Captain.
Nev.
Avis. I'm sorry I woke you.
Nevin, you've been on edge for weeks. You need to talk to me.
Yes, I do. It's about Corey. I have feelings for him.
I think I knew that. I've been hiding from it as much as I think you were. We both need to do something about it.
What do you mean? Avis, what are you doing?
I'm not angry with you, Nevin. I want you to be happy. But that can't happen with me here. I'm leaving right away, so you have no reason not to deal with this.
Tara.
Bye, Nevin.
Nevin, I'm sorry to interrupt, but I have some bad news.
Matt? You're back?
It's about Andy. You haven't answered your door in days, Sital. I'm worried.
I assure you, your concern is unnecessary, Lieutenant.
You shouldn't grieve for him alone. We can help each other through this.
I do not require assistance. I am not grieving. I am waiting. I will be prompt to my next duty shift, Lieutenant. Thank you for your visit.